Okay, I want to do a quick review of Captain America. I am level 95 with him now. He's going to be my fourth level 100. I've been enjoying him quite a bit. I'm not an expert on him by any means, but I want to let you know how I feel about him having played him, because I think he's extraordinarily fun, and I think he kind of gets a little bit of a bad rep. Right before I started leveling him, people were telling me it's a rough leveling experience. You're not going to like him. You know, his moves feel bad. And to be honest, I haven't experienced any of that at all. So the reason I'm making this video is for people that are considering playing Captain America, but maybe have heard some bad press about him, just to tell you, I think you should try him because he's actually really fun. And I kind of want to break down why I like him in particular, okay? So these mobs here are kind of stronger mobs, but the ultimate damage does a bazillion damage to them. Look, being able to do half somebody's health from just a normal Sakaar mob when you're doing these quests is pretty good. So I noticed right off the bat that his ult is not bad. Plus it's a provoke, which is pretty nice. And it also is a pretty wide range and you can aim it on a particular person so you can group people up in an AoE then down or whatever. So the ultimate's been pretty good. On top of it, I've also noticed that Captain America, almost all of the variety of his move all seem like they have some decent use. I haven't got them all the way to level 15 yet. I've been, you know, I got to get the gold and everything, but I'm leveling them as I can. But it seems to me like each one has some sort of variant that I would like. Like one's going to make him, you know, gap close. The other one's going to send somebody up in the air. So it has different types of utility. Like, each move has a different variant, like a high DPS variant or one that's more of a guard breaker or whatever. It doesn't seem like there's a lot of wasted moves. Like for instance, on Storm, there's a couple moves that are basically just complete garbage you're never gonna use. Whereas on this guy, it really seems like each version does something. Like for instance, this is another example here. He hits and jumps on an enemy, kicks him, deals damage and knocks him down. Or this one is going to bleed them, which is a totally different effect. And it decreases their HP recovery by 50% for 7 seconds. So, I mean, there's a total valid reason for wanting each one of those, not to mention the guard break changes. So I could go on and on. He's got counterattacks, which is one of the only people I've seen that got counterattack mechanics. He's got actually a formidable amount of melee DPS, more than I would have thought. He's the only person I've seen that actually has a heal in the game for himself and increases his HP recovery. He's definitely the only person I've seen that's got an AoE shield they can put on everybody. You know, he feels to me like the type of character that is very well overall designed and built. Like pretty much everything in his kit seems to make sense. There's a few fundamental flaws, like people that can fly, you're really stuck at trying to throw stuff at them because you can't really get up there. And in the duos, people can fly way above you where you're kind of stuck. And you know, I think that cheese just needs to get fixed, but it doesn't really take away from the character as much as the design of the game. He's also extremely tanky. Now, to be fair, I did get 6-star boots, which just gave me some tankiness, but it did row just the stamina recovery and didn't go too crazy in the HP and stuff. And then the rest is just blue and whatnot. But I also moved badges over. So my leveling experience was not that bad because I moved over some badges. He's my fourth character I've leveled. So I had squad rank behind me, moved over badges, bought the $3.99 pack. And then I happened to have 6-star boots that I pulled on him there too. So I have a little bit of a variety on him. It puts him up to about 260,000 power. So he's not ridiculous. Okay. Most people beat Maestro right around, I think it's 250. So I probably got 20 to 30,000 more power than the average bear at the moment. I will say that Captain America also seems very, very, very unkillable in PvP if you get extremely tanky. Captain Americas that are at my Storm's power, like 850,000, they are terrifying because they can be so tanky, and they can build up something else that Captain America has called this vibrarium gauge or something. I forget exactly how to pronounce it, but basically it's sort of like a stamina gauge that builds up instead of down. And then when you're at 100%, whatever move that you use next that has a bonus effect that happens at 100%, we'll use that 100%. And then your other move will do something additional, like do more damage or an effect or whatever. So he has sort of like a combo-like mechanic that is unique to him. He's also very, 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 very good at guard breaking. And if you look, he also has in his potential lots of guard damage decrease. They make him sort of a person that is hard to land debuffs on, hard to guard break, and he focuses on guard breaking enemies. And if you look at his specialization, he does have amazing specializations. One in particular over here increases guard damage for 10 seconds when using the Vibrarium release class skill down. So basically when you're using that gauge we were talking about, you get an increase in guard damage, and that goes up to 28% increased guard damage, which is insane. And that's before we start talking about, you know, the other stats you can pick up, etc. I'm not going to go detailed into the specializations, you get it, okay? And you can pick up even Omega cards that have guard damage percentage as their primary stat. So there is ways you can use that to your advantage. And plus him being so tanky, I just use that HP recovery. Most people tend to use the shield. I'm just using the HP recovery because it helps him stay alive and helps him use less potions. And it's been a really enjoyable leveling experience for me. He does have difficulty on some of the bosses because of the melee, so you have to be pretty much manually playing through most of the bosses. But for these little mini bosses like the one we're about to do here, he doesn't really have any problem. Maybe you gotta just hit the ultimate, you know, and you know, watch it a little bit. But no, he's fun too, because his play style is you can sit back and land, you can land your shields, which bounce between people, and you can get credit for hitting multiple people. See, I guard broke this guy already. He's not even half HP. That's what I'm talking about, the guard break. Or you can play a real supportive role of like shielding your teammates and then trying to jump in and guard break people to get on top of them, etc. He's kind of, I want to say a tank, but there's not really too much of a tank role in the game. It does seem to me like guard break seems to generate the most aggro that I've seen in the game. In there you saw the health recovery from both the potion but also the ability as well. There hasn't been any system in the game that explains the aggro system, but from what I've seen, it's based upon guard break. So the fact that he's the most defensive character but also seems to have the highest guard break is great, because it also means he can sort of be the tank in the game where, you know, the PvE bosses focus you or whatever. But really, it boils down in PvE fights that the basic attack damage, it almost doesn't matter, and it almost always comes down to the abilities they're doing. You just can't get hit by. So tanking doesn't really seem to be a massive thing. Plus, in the end game, your alliance just swarms all the bosses anyway. So from what I've seen, tanking isn't really a thing. And for the most part, you just want more DPS. And if somebody dies in the dark zone, you know, so be it. They'll just fly right back. That being said, Captain America is still kind of nuts because he's pretty unkillable, has insane guard damage increase as well as decrease, is got fairly decent ranged abilities, but he's definitely more of an in-close guy, and he has more damage than people think, even though he's a tank. That's the other part, is his damage is actually good, borderline great. Like, he has a few few moves, which are just a bunch of punches, basically, or some circle spinning, you know, type of moves, and, you know, full-on, like, Whirlwind Barbarian style. And those moves actually do a bajillion damage. Plus, he has, see, there's guard break. So, guard breaking people helps in PvE a lot too, because it really makes the experience a lot easier on auto. You're guard breaking people all the time, and your guard break doesn't happen to you as often. We're about to get guard broke right here, I think, actually, by this guy. Yep, there it is, ourselves. And you can just hit space bar or just hit the button or whatever, and then you can use your damage. And the element's so cool because it decreases the damage, but also the more you get hit, the more damage you deal. There's almost 120,000 damage with really basically only tanky stats. You know, for being a tanky guy, he does an absolute ton of damage. So if you're thinking about playing Captain America, yeah, you know, I would give you a thumbs up as a main character. Currently, the highest power person in the game is Aatrox, and he has over 1 million power, and he is Captain America. So shout out to him. Great character. And Aatrox is basically unkillable. I mean, I don't think I could kill him if I just sat there and hammered away on him. So if that's the style you want to play, you should play Captain America. If this video was informative or helped you at all, consider liking, subscribing, because that helps me. All right, and goodbye.